Hey everyone, in this video we're going to be talking about the fixed point method, in particular the theory behind it and how it actually works. So, the fixed point method is an open root finding method much like many of the other techniques that we have talked about in our previous videos, such as Newton's method. As a way of understanding, let's say that we are asked to solve for the root of the function f of x is equal to x cubed plus x minus 0.5. Graphically, this function looks something like this. Well, isn't it true that at our roots, we can say that f of x is equal to 0, meaning that our y value is 0? We certainly can, as this is the definition of a function's roots. As fixed point method is a root finding method, we want to find out approximately what that x value is going to be. We can do so by first finding a function that has our f of x term set to 0. This is what we are going to call g of x. Therefore, when f of x is equal to 0, x is going to equal g of x. So, in our example here, we'll set our functions to 0 and solve for our next iteration of x. These are two ways that you could go about doing it in this problem. I'm just going to call them g1 of x and g2 of x. Let's just go ahead and plot them both on our graph here. As you can see, both of these intersect with a point directly above our root of interest. That is our fixed point. Hence the name of this method. This is the point where x is going to equal g of x. So, moving forward, you could choose either one of these g of x's, and I'll talk about later about why we have more than one. But just know at this stage, we typically have multiple valid options. So, how do we translate that bit of information into an actual algorithm that can help us solve for our roots? Well, we can just say that g of x is going to equal f of x plus x. So, for example, if we were present on a root, f of x would equal 0, and then our above statement would be valid as expected, right? So, algorithmically, we are going to find our next iteration of x by plugging in our previous value of x into our g of x equation until our statement x is equal to g of x is true. So, to better understand all this, let's just choose an arbitrary starting value, x is equal to 0.1. We plug that value into g1 of x, and we get 0.499. We go directly across, and then we ping off the x equals x line and arrive at our second x guess, and evaluate our g of x term again to be 0.375. We just continue this process until our error is acceptable. Our error for this method is simply the difference between our next x value and our current x value, and we continue iterating until this is below our acceptable value. In the coming videos, I will solve a few problems by hand, in Excel, Google Sheets, etc., so you can check out those videos if you are all still confused on the fixed point method. I hope that this video helped you, and if you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.